So how do you use the basic Thinkorswim platform to read stock charts? In this video, I'm going to walk you through what I consider to be the best charting software there is out there, and on top of that, it's free. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps I took to go from trading with a full-time job to trading as a full-time job. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And today we're going over the Thinkorswim platform. So for those who don't know, the Thinkorswim platform is through the brokerage platform TD Ameritrade. And all you have to do to get this software is just open an account with them. You don't have to pay any fees or subscriptions for the platform. And you actually don't have to deposit any money. So you can have an account with nothing in it and use this platform. If you're at all serious about getting into stock trading, I would suggest get on this platform as soon as possible and get familiar with it, because you will want to use this platform as much as possible and not have to get used to it once you start trading after you've been maybe using a easier web-based platform for a while. So when you first open that platform, it should look relatively like this. And this will be the home screen, which just gives you basic info about either trades or just your account and what you have going on. And then on the sides, you will have other information, which is right now it has watch lists on the side, which is basically a list of stocks that you have made that you essentially want to watch or look out for. And you can remove these side tabs by just clicking on these buttons. You will spend most of your time up here in this row of tabs. And you have the monitor tab, which will give you a more detailed description of your active trades or positions you have. And then if you actually want to make a trade, you go to the trade tab. And what you do up here is you would type in the symbol of the stock you want to trade. So let's trade Amazon. And what that does is then that brings up the current price of Amazon and the net change for the day. And as well down here, you have an options chain, which is just a different asset you can trade on Amazon. But how to make a simple buy or sell entry? You go up here and click on either the ask if you want to buy or the bid if you want to sell. And so if we click on the ask, down here you can see it brings up a buy order. And so what this says is we are buying stock, we are buying it. This says 100 shares, it'll default to 100 shares, but we can go down here and change it. And it'll actually looks like it changes by increments of 100. So if I just wanted to buy one, because Amazon is pretty expensive at $1,900 a share right now. And then if we go along here, it says to open because we are initiating this order. We don't have any shares of Amazon right now, so we need to open. And that's just a technical term for essentially just buying a new position. And then it says we're buying Amazon, type stock. And then this is the actual price down here that we would be buying it at. And this is a set for a limit order. And that means that we are buying it at this price. So we can lock in that price if we don't want it to change based on the changing price of Amazon. But if we have it unlocked, it sticks to the ask price of Amazon. And so we can then change this to however we want, if we want to buy it at a certain price. And then over here it says day, and that is how long the order will be open for. So if we have this at a price that's really low below the market that no one's going to fill us at, like let's say 500, no one's going to fill us at $500 because that's well below the current price of Amazon. No one's going to sell you one share of Amazon for $500 when it's almost worth $2,000. They would be locking in a huge loss on their part. Moving on, we have how long the order is going to last. And so right now it says day, and that means that if this order doesn't get filled within the day, it'll cancel and close itself automatically. If you want to have a buy order open for maybe a whole week and see if Amazon pulls back to that price, let's say you have a buy order at $1,800 and you think Amazon's going to fall $100 in the next week, you can have that at good till cancel or GTC. and that will essentially have that order open until you cancel it. And then exchange, that means that it will go to the best exchange possible, and that'll just get you essentially the best fill and the fastest fill possible. To actually send the order, you would click confirm and send, and it brings up here that we want to buy one Amazon at $500, good till cancel. It says it'll cost $505, and that's because buying stock, you do have a transaction fee to the broker of $5. To send that order in, we would go ahead and click send order, and that sends our order in. Up here you can see it says I got rejected because I don't have enough cash or buying power in this account to buy and pay for that one share. But if you did, you could go into your monitor tab, and under working orders here, it would show that you had one order open for a share of Amazon at $500, good till cancel. And then once that order got filled, it would show in the filled orders down here, and it would also show up down here in your positions, and that's where you could track your P&L or your profit loss for that position or one share of Amazon that you purchased. But most of your time you will be spending in the charts tab up here, and this is where we can see the charts and price action of all the stocks that we either want to trade or just keep track of. Right now, up here on the left, you can see that based on this ticker symbol or the symbol associated with the stock, Amazon is still on here. And right here, you can see the current price of Amazon and then the price change for the day. And that doesn't matter on what time frame of chart you're looking, it'll always say how much change happened this day for Amazon. To quickly show you how to just move the charts around and zoom in when you want to do that, if you want to zoom in, the easiest way is to click it with your left mouse and drag on a section you want to zoom in. So if I wanted to zoom in on this section, I would click and drag this box over and it would zoom me in. If I wanted to zoom back out, I would right click and click auto zoom, and that resets it to the 2-day time frame that this chart is set at. Another way to do it is go down here and click and drag on these two axes, the X and Y axis, and that'll zoom and also stretch the Y axis. Also, if you click control while dragging on the axis, it will move them around instead of expanding or contracting them. And that's just another way to manipulate the chart into fitting on your screen exactly how you want it to. Right now, this chart is only showing the open trading market hours. And what those hours are 9:30 Eastern time to 4 Eastern time. If you want the extended hour session, or if your chart is showing the extended hour session and you want it off, you go up here to this little gear, which is the settings button. And we would go over to equities because we are in stocks right now and those are equities. And then we would go down here and show extended hours, or if you don't want them, you click that off and then hit OK. And then we can see that this shows the extended hours, which is this lighter shade of black down here compared to the straight up black color of the open market hours. Down here, these blue lines down here is volume. And so if you're never sure which you're looking at, the volume bars will always be a lot larger in the actual open trading hours of the day, because 99% of the volume happens in the open market hours. We can zoom out again because this is showing more data now because we have the extended hours on it. But you can see that in these after hours that the market will still be a lot more jumpy and all over the place without candles that look a lot more defined. Going back into the settings just to show you a few other things. This is just your general settings. This is where you would overlap the volume. And so if we wanted to take that off the chart and have it in its own section, we could hit apply, and you can see that down here, it puts it in its own little graph. But I like to have this on the chart because it blends in really well and it makes it so the chart doesn't take up more space. Another thing I would suggest is going to snapped drawings and putting OHLC on here. And what that does is your drawings will snap to the candlestick wicks or bars. This allows you to draw lines really easily of either trends, highs, or Fibonacci levels. I suggest just going through a lot of these and looking through and playing with the different settings, because you can really change these charts to how you want them to look. And this time axis, this is where we could change the chart time and candlestick size. So if we wanted a 10-minute candle and over a 5-day chart, this is where we can change that. I'm gonna go in here and change the after hours off again, because generally when you're looking at stocks, you really don't need those after hour data, because 99% of the trading happens in the open market hours. So we're just gonna go ahead and click OK, and that should adjust the chart to the new settings of 5 days with 10-minute candles. Another quick way to change the time frame is actually right here next to the gears, you have your favorites. And so this is just basic ones that they give you right off the bat that are in the platform. But these are generally really good hours. If we wanted to change it to a daily chart for more long-term trading, this shows a year worth of data with each candle being a day. And if we wanted to zoom in on the chart, we could do that and maybe look at a certain section a little bit more closely. Down here, you can see it has the earnings reports. And so this is just where you can see that this is where previous earnings were. If we scroll to the right, we can see this is where the next earnings date will be. And it says that they are reported on this day after market hours. Some will report before market hours. So if you're close to earnings, make sure to look at that. Next over here, we have drawings. And if we go down here to drawing tools, there are a ton of different drawings. Right now we have a channel selected. And so if we just select that again, just to make sure that you have it, you can go onto the chart and click where you would want to draw the candle. And since we have that snap to the candlestick wick selected, it'll easily snap to the exact low of that candle. And then we can draw the channel that we're maybe looking for. And so this will first draw the bottom part of the channel. And so that looks like a good support line. And then we would click again, and that will make the other parallel line that we can use for the other side of the channel. And we'll put that exactly right here because that looks like a good channel for Amazon. And then click again, and that will show you the channel. And we can use this then to buy or sell and just trade Amazon every few days based on this channel. If you want to edit this, you can go into edit properties, and you can change a lot of different things, either the label or the name. You can make the lines extend forever. You can change the color. You can change the width size of it. And you can also save your settings as a default. So if you want something to look different or be a different way every time, it'll do that. If we wanted to go back and get another drawing, we can. And just to demonstrate the snap to level, you can see that here it will snap to this high without having to draw it perfectly, and that makes it so you can draw resistance levels really easily without having to eyeball them and type in the exact price on the drawing editor. To get rid of these drawings, we can either right click them and remove drawing, or we can just right click anywhere on the chart and clear drawing set if we want to remove all the drawings on the chart and just get a clean slate. So if you want to have studies on your chart, we would go to the studies tab, and you can do quick studies and either find a study in here if you want, or you can go to edit studies, which is what I usually do, because you can then go in here and search for the study you want. So let's search for a simple moving average, and we can put that on the chart. And then if you right click on here and click edit properties, we can go in and edit the moving average. So we can change it to a 10 simple day moving average. We can change the color, the length, what it looks like. There's a lot of different editing you can do. And I know this is a ton of information at one time, but that's why I think you should start soon working with this platform and get familiar with it, because it is a lot of work and pretty overwhelming at the start. So if we go ahead and apply this, you can see that it is now on our chart here, and that we have that simple moving average. And if we wanted to use that to trade, we could. So a really awesome thing about Thinkorswim is if you have a chart set up that you want every time and you move it around between different charts, you can go up to studies again. And let's just put another study in here so we can have a better example. So let's say we use this setup for our trading plan and we want to save this. So then you can go in and save as study set. And let's just save this as simple trading plan. This is something we could load up every time. So if we wanted to quickly load this up and we didn't have any of these studies on, we could go in here and click load study, and we can see that we have that simple trading plan here. And if we click that, it would then load it on this chart and override anything we already had. Hey, thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about the Thinkorswim platform, check out this playlist I have right here. And if you just want to learn more about trading, make sure to subscribe to the channel. As always, leave any comments or questions below. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up.